Okay, so I'm going to attempt to give you an update on President Trump. He went to a GOP meeting. It was kind of like a rally today in Georgia. And forgive me for not being able to share all the details because I just can't remember them all. So I encourage you to probably one of the best places to find his speeches because they always broadcast his speeches is Right Side Broadcasting Network, RSBN. You can find them on Twitter. You can find them on YouTube, hopefully, if they have not been banned on there. Sometimes they block them, which is terrible. But you can also find them on Rumble. Okay, so I encourage you to watch any rally of President Trump. I believe he got on the plane and flew to North Carolina or South Carolina for another speech today. So he was very, looked very good and upbeat and happy, and very, of course, concerned about these sham witchcraft indictments, which are totally bogus, just created for to target, get Trump, because they hate him so much. And so, but he was very just. Looked great, sounded great, and we just lift him up to you, Lord. And we continue to pray against the demons right now that are working through the Injustice Department, the Biden Justice Department. It's obvious that he has been a target from by the Democrats ever since he came down that escalator at Trump Tower. And it is sickening and sad and sick and sinister. And I say that with every bit of disgust in my voice. And thank God I'm not cussing today. But anyway, that's the deal. And I've been following this ever since. Every bit of crap and garbage they have been throwing at him straight from hell. And if you don't believe that, that's fine. I encourage you to dig deeper. And this could be anybody. This could be you. This could be you. They target people for political purposes to intimidate them. And I take authority over those demons from hell right now. And you need to stop it, devil, because this is not America. And I curse you at the root with every fiber of my being. I bind you in Jesus Christ's holy name. I push back and I bind you and I pray for God's Holy Spirit to convict these vicious people. Because I never ever thought I would ever see this. The only reason I fight back so hard is because it's so vicious, it's so evil. Here he is, announces his presidency, and all of a sudden, if you don't know what has been going on, you just don't know. Because this started with Hillary, and it started with the Russia, which has totally been totally debunked. Everything they do to him gets totally debunked. They came against him from using Twitter. Thank God Elon Musk bought Twitter because this was a place where you could not even talk about anything over there. I went for months and months and months not sharing things that I still don't share some things because I don't trust. I say I'll stay a little gaslit if you don't mind because you don't know down the line who is going to this and who is going to that. And they are vicious. But we are winning. We are winning because God is good and good wins. Good, the goodness of God was meant to win in this earth. Okay, the goodness of God is Jesus Christ healing the masses. If the church would only believe, okay, believe, 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 believe. Okay, it's His will for us to be healthy and healed. It is God's will for us to have every need met. That is the goodness of God. He did it for us. He died so that we could be His heir, H-E-I-R, heirs of Christ, heirs of God in Christ Jesus. It's supposed to be like the Garden of Eden. That's what it's supposed to be like. Don't settle for anything less. Okay? This is why we come against the devil. This is why I come against the devil. Because it is not God's will for us to be in a car accident. It is not God's will for you to die of cancer. It is not God's will for us to be in lack. Now, yes, we go through this place in our time where we say, we trust you, God. And He meets every single day. He meets our needs. So trust Him in Jesus' name and believe. And I believe for you. If you can't believe, you know I'm here and I believe for you. I believe for you. The intercessors have to believe for the people, even the people that are unbelievers. And we have to believe for the body of Christ. And so, Lord, I just lift it up to you. I pray for the church. I pray for the pastors. Yes, Lord, I have been critical of these things, Lord, and situations, but only because you allowed me to see things and for the good. And so we cast the devil out of all of us. We ask you to forgive us, Lord, for all of our sins. I'm chiefest, okay? I am chiefest. I humble myself before you, God, and publicly and confess I have sinned. And God, you know all my sins, but I thank you that you have forgiven all my sins. And so we keep a daily tab, Lord. When your Holy Spirit convicts us of sin, we go to you, and you are our interceder also, Lord. And you are our lawyer. You are the great lawyer, the great attorney before God and the devil. You, Father, defend us in battle as a lawyer under spiritual law. That's how good you are, God. And so I just intercede. I intercede for President Trump that you, Jesus Christ, would be his greatest lawyer and that you give his attorneys wisdom. When he goes to court on Tuesday, you're there with him. You say, don't worry. Don't worry about what you will say. Your Holy Spirit will give them the wisdom at the time. So yes, prepare. But Father, we give him peace and protection against this vile, vicious enemy behind the scenes working in our America, in our law enforcement. Shame on you. Shame on you. And another thing, he is for law enforcement. He is for law enforcement. He is for the good things. If there's anything in his life that he is planning for that's not good, that's not of God, God, you touch him and give him wisdom about those things. But Father, I thank you for his success, Lord. And I thank you for our success and the people of America and our success, and touch these countries around the world where there's great persecution and murder of Christians in Africa. It's either Nigeria or Uganda. I don't remember which. I'll have to go over the story again. But just yesterday, 300 Christians died from murder. We bind it. We, as the church in America, have to intercede for these people that might not have it as good as we do. We might not even have it very good, but we have it better than some, okay? And so we are expected to pray and intercede. And we do that, Lord. And we give you all the praise and glory now for all the answered prayer. And we're going to keep on binding the devil because I don't trust him one second of this day. So thank you, Lord. Victory is ours in Jesus Christ's holy name. Amen. God bless. Have a great day. Thanks for watching. Leave your comments, your questions, your desire if you want me to talk about something special. If I can, I will. Lord willing, and He is. Okay? God bless.